This Bible was brought to me a few years ago for restoration. It was beyond restoring, so it was not done. But the etchings that were inside it, the steel point etchings, were quite incredible, and they inspired me to possibly look at using some of the compositions there. And the first one that was attempted was this painting behind me, which is the Hill of Skulls, as I call it, or of course everybody will recognize it as the Crucifixion. Notice the heavy texture on the canvas surface. This is the pure beeswax mixed with the oil pigment that gives it this particular type of texture. The wax is heated in electric palette to approximately 240 degrees, and then the oil or the dry pigment is added. It dries almost instantly on the canvas and is difficult to manipulate with a brush and takes some practice to make it work. This type of painting is called encaustic and was first used by the Greeks in the 4th century BC. They painted mostly on pottery. From the Middle Ages until the 18th century, it was considered a lost art. It resurfaced in the 1950s with the American pop art scene by artists like Jasper Johns, Roy Lichtenstein, and others. It's taken me a few years and several additives like boiled linseed oil, thinners, and adhesives to really get the feel of this media. Its main attribute is it will dry quickly, allowing for instant overpainting. I like the pastel feeling when it is dry, when it dries, and it doesn't require a varnish or sealer protective like glass. It also can be moved around by using a heat gun to melt the surface, and then you get beautiful happenings with it that you could not get with a brush. This group of paintings was inspired by my trip to London in 2006. From photo reference that I took at St. Paul's Cathedral, around the exterior of Buckingham Palace, and visits to St. Martin in the Fields opposite Trafalgar Square. Given the subject matter, I felt it would be more interesting to show the work in London than in, say, Nova Scotia or Western Canada.